Today, we are in Selma, Alabama. Selma is a community south of Montgomery that was a Jewish settlement before the Civil War. But 100 years after the Civil War, there was another meeting here in Selma. This meeting was led by John Lewis from Troy, Alabama, who was the president of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, often referred to as SNCC, and Reverend Hosea Williams. Reverend Williams was the local representative of the Southern Christian Leadership Conference. Together they led 600 marchers who gathered behind this church and marched up the street on March 7, 1965. They marched towards the Edmund Pettus Bridge, over the Alabama River, and 50 miles lay in front of them to Montgomery. It was the purpose of this group to impress upon Governor George Wallace that the black citizens of Alabama, here in Dallas County, and in Lowndes County, and in Montgomery County, were not given their full rights since the end of the Civil War, 100 years before. Now we're going to take that walk. We're going to walk up to the Edmund Pettus Bridge. We're going to go over the bridge, where on the other side of that bridge, they were met by resistance from the state police of Alabama. Let's take that walk. The marchers turned onto Selma Street from Brown Memorial Chapel, which is three traffic signals behind me. They walked up Selma Drive to Broad Street here in downtown Selma, the main thoroughfare. From there, the 600 marchers took a left turn, heading towards the Edmund Pettus Bridge to cross over the Alabama River and onto State Route 80 and head towards the Capitol. That's the direction we're going to take now.
After 4 o'clock on that bloody Sunday afternoon, with many of the marchers having come directly from their church services, and they were all dressed in their Sunday best. Many of the women wore high heels and coats, and men were dressed in suits and ties. The marchers walked over the crest of this bridge, and they looked down the slope of the bridge across to the east bank of the Alabama River. The end of that bridge also marked the boundary of the Selma city limits. But blocking their path to cross the border of the city limits, the marchers saw this. It was a line of Alabama state troopers. And the troopers were backed by the Dallas County Sheriff Jim Clark, who was directing his deputies from his patrol car. Many of the deputies were mounted on horseback. Their sole purpose was to prevent the marchers from leaving the city and entering the territory of Dallas County. They were dressed in full riot gear with gas masks on, holding their batons and ready for battle. In spite of this strong show of force with all the firepower against them, John Lewis was not intimidated in turning the marchers around. He led the marchers to the bottom of the bridge, knowing that the result would be catastrophic. In fact, the treatment at the hands of the police was inhumanely brutal. As I walked across this bridge, even after 45 years, I could still feel the emotion from what occurred on that day. I could feel Major John Cloud, the commander of the state troopers, as he yelled through his bullhorn, "This is an unlawful assembly." He then ordered the marchers to return to their church or their homes. But John Lewis issued a message by word of mouth passed back among the marchers. He told them to kneel and pray. I could feel it as I got to that point. When he told them to kneel and pray, the message didn't travel fast enough. Major Cloud's message traveled much quicker, and he issued his order, and he said, "Troopers, advance." Clouds of smoke arose in the form of tear gas. As the marchers fled from the gas, troopers and deputies chased after them. they cruelly beat each of the marchers that they caught. People were beaten to the ground, where they were overcome by the drifting tear gas, and the gas was making everybody vomit. Once the marchers fell to the ground, then they were trampled by the deputies on horseback. Those marchers that stayed on their feet were chased back over the bridge and all the way back to Brown's Chapel. Sheriff Clark also took his turn at beating the marchers with his baton. The emotion is still there. You feel it as you walk the bridge and as you walk the route to and from Brown's Chapel. All of this happened only 45 years ago, while our country was going about its merry business, singing the beautiful words of that song, "I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. I've even got the month of May with my girl."